In terms of how I foresee growth clinically, what I think is potentially missing though is like a structure or a framework to that growth. Is that if you think about it like a continuum, is that irrespective of whatever you do, you will grow just by design, it'll just happen and you'll get better over time. But without having, and I hate to say it, without actually having a process or an actual framework to that, it can kind of go left, right, up, down, backwards, sideways, all over the place, circle around. Like there isn't an actual path for that progression moving forward. What I've noticed with dietitians or in general, like as a collective, is that the way in which dietitians are doing that is by specialising, you know, picking a niche.
Yeah.
I can't be good at everything, so therefore I'm going to niche. Because that's the only way for me to direct my clinical development and my education is to be good at only one thing. So in terms of your growth and the way you're thinking about clinical growth is left, right and centre, jumping all over the place without a pattern. Like there's no framework for it. And it's a head fuck. Like you're actually confused by it all. I don't know where to focus. I don't know where to put my energy. What should I be doing? And the same as all new graduates, when you come out, you're out and you're like, I've got all this knowledge and I just want all this knowledge. The difference with improving on that is the navigation of the process of that knowledge with an actual client. Sorry, in terms of clinical growth, the way I think about it is not just an increase in knowledge, because knowledge will happen and you all do that well. To a point, like it is like riding a bike, so the more conversations you have about certain topics, you don't need to continually boost that knowledge because you've got it. But it might be, like Larissa said, a different way to approach it. But the framework, I think, in terms of clinical reasoning, from my perspective and in terms of my growth, is that. That is at the crux of it. And that can be a really, really good way to keep your clinical reasoning in check and to start to re-challenge and have a different perspective or a different thought around some of the information that they're presenting to you. And one of the biggest things in that is definitely time. And in time, you will get better, but there's also time you will stay stagnant too, unless you're constantly being challenged. But it's just trying to find ways that work. And in terms of improving knowledge in clinical teaching and teaching in general, there isn't research to suggest that this is the optimum way to learn or to get better. And that's because there isn't, because it's individual to the person and it's individual to you. Challenging yourself to do other things. So if you go back and have a look at your initial GP letters and what they are now, what your notes look like now, could they be better then, essentially? Are you good at communicating your assessments in a written way? Are you better at giving them verbally? Do you struggle with the verbal communication? Strategies that I use, make yourself assess that diet and deliver that back to your client. And these are not skills that you're taught at uni. And this is the point, right, is that you're taught at uni to focus on how to do, you know, diet disease education, right, how to put together a nutrition plan, how to write a clinical note. That's it.